Recently, I was asked how to make a hat with four sections to the top and doing short rows. And I actually got it done. So let me show you how I made this hat. Now, for this hat, I did get 5.5 stitches and 8 rows per inch. This is for a small child. If you're making it larger, of course it's going to be more stitches and more rows. But the pattern I came up with said to cast on 88 stitches. I like to have an odd number of stitches when I do rib, so I cast it on 87 stitches, did 12 rows, increased one stitch at the end. Then I did 40 rows for the body. Now I'm going to work the top or the crown of the hat. So I need to do this in four parts. With 88 stitches divided in two, that's divided in two is 44, and then that divided in half is 22. So each section is going to have 22 needles. I do need to get my claw weights on here because I'm doing the short rows. I'm going to set my carriage. In this case, the two front levers here are actually they're the Russell levers, because when you look at it, it has the Roman numeral 1 and 2, and the other one has the triangle and the circle. So when it comes to studio Silver Reed Singer machines, you have the side and the Russell levers. So now, what I'm going to do is short row. I have the first stitch on the side of the carriage. Bring it out to hold, knit across. I take the next stitch on the left here, put it out to hold, knit across. And I'm going to continue doing the short rows till I'm down to two stitches. Now, there comes a time when you have to take and move your claw weights up. Some machines more often than others. I should probably remove my comb to get it out of the way. So, okay, that's going to wrap. And then I can go down to one claw weight. So there's the two final stitches. I am going to bring all the needles now right of zero, but only up until right here into the forward working position. And now I'm going to knit across. I need to bring my claw weight over, but also, because I'm only going to be working on the next 22 stitches, I have to put the first section, to hold position. So again, I'm going to short row down to the two stitches. Move the claw weights up as needed. Actually, that last stitch came undone because I don't have enough weight on there. Let me hand knit that back. Remove the one weight, put the other weight there. I'm down to the two stitches. Now I am going to, oops, okay, so now I gotta take 22 left of zero and all the needles over to where I'm working now, out to forward. I'm gonna knit across, and I should have hung the claw weights there, but I could still do it now. And I do have to take the last set, which is right of zero, and put those out to hold. Okay, looks like I may have to re-knit a couple stitches there. I should have done that before I pushed these needles back before I removed it. There we go. So now I'm going to do the same on these 22 stitches and the same on the last 24 to the left here. So I got the two stitches here. This is the last section. I don't have any more needles here. But I do need to get the carriage over here to the left. So I push these needles here to the forward working position, knit across. I am going to pull those back out to hold in position, but I'm going to take my front levers and push them back. Now, from here, what I did was, to make it a little bit easier, is I went up to tension dial 9 because I want to do this last row with larger stitches so I could do the latched hold bind off. Now, you could do whatever bind off you want if you want to do the back stitch bind off. I still recommend doing one last row across because you have some needles that have two loops over them from doing the short rows before. You would keep it at the same tension dial that you were using. A little bit harder when you're working from the side. Okay, so I actually want to bring these needles back out to hold in position. And I did notice one or two stitches over there that did not knit. I'll get to those in a moment. And now all I do is I'm going to take my small hook, and I am going to go in the first loop, pull that needle back, go into the second loop, and have that second loop in the hook, pull that needle back, pull the second loop through the first loop, go in the third loop, have it in the hook, pull the third loop through the second loop, and do that all the way down. So this is my bind off edge. So you end up with a piece of fabric like this. I did start out with a long tail in the beginning because I'm going to use that to sew up the back seam of this. And I did leave a tail at the end here, but this I may have to cut because we have two seams at the top. So here's the back seam here, and I can go across that, but then I need the other one to go across that way. Now, after I just sewn up the back seam in one part of the side of the triangle there, and I stopped at the end there. Now, I need to go across So what I did was I found the top stitch on both sides here. And it doesn't matter if you're one off, because when I sew the other seam, it's going to match up. You could hide. Well, I did get a little hole in the other one, but. So I pull that up tight. And then I do my back and forth. Well, I could take that off now. Running stitch sewing. And then, of course, at the end of this one, I need to weave in the yarn tail. And then I'll go to the other one. I'll weave in the yarn tail here, sew up there, weave in the yarn tail there, and I'm all done. Now I'm doing that same hat, but instead of short rowing, I am decreasing one stitch on each side every other row, and then I leave a tail at the end for sewing. That may make a better seam. Of course, I won't know until I get to that point. But I'm doing 80 stitches this time, so it's 20 stitches for each section. So I knit two rows, and then I like to take the two-prong transfer tool and push, put the second stitch on that second needle, or two stitches on that second needle in. And because I have my carriage set to hold, I cannot just put those needles out. If I do that, I just have to put them back. And for the machines that don't knit from this position, just put them back to the forward working position. Knit two rows. And I'm going to decrease down until I get two stitches. Now on the last one, I am going to have to take the end stitch and put it to the center one, so there will be two needles with two stitches. I'll knit across, and then I will bind off those last two stitches and then go to the next section. So there's the first one I did, I steamed. The second one that I showed in the recording. This one here I just showed about doing the decreases instead. And yes, I'm going to have more yarn tails to hide, but it's really up to you on which way you want this to look.